Dear Excellencies and valued guests, in my role as the Director of Mahila Housing Seva Trust India and a member of the Ensure Resilience Global Partnership Gender Working Group, it is an honor for me to speak to you today, to a diverse community of champions for gender equality and climate justice. I represent women from the informal sector living in urban slums, who are invariably at the receiving end of many deprivations, structural, social, economic, and environmental. We are all experiencing the increasing impacts of climate change around the world. However, to understand why the poor are particularly exposed to climate risk, we need to take a deeper look into the roots of risk. In many countries, significant socioeconomic inequalities between women and men limit women's access to education, property, decision-making, financial assets, and other resources. MHT's long presence on the ground tells us that women face informational, technical, behavioral, institutional, and financial barriers. Women, especially in developing countries, are at increasingly high risk of suffering losses and damages from climate change. And please note, these are not just economic, but also non-economic in nature. What do gender discriminatory norms and inequalities result in? They create a reinforcing causal loop that continually diminishes women's adaptive capacity. Not only this, it mutes their response to climate stressors. Let me explain this. In city after city, women perceived climate change as an act of God, beyond one's control. We found a correlation between the behavior anomalies like narrow framing or loss aversion in poor women when it comes to responding to climate challenges and their resignation to fate. Building resilience of urban poor is a compelling challenge, but under these circumstances, it becomes a daunting one too. To address this issue, we need global consolidated cooperation of stakeholders from the macro to the micro level. Later today, at an event held at the Canadian Pavilion, the Ensure Resilience Center of Excellence for Gender Smart Solutions will be launched. This Ensure Resilience Center of Excellence aims to fill the knowledge and action gap on gender equitable disaster risk management strategies and will provide guidance to practitioners on innovative solutions. It offers the world's first platform to collect, bundle, generate, and coordinate information and knowledge on gender-related aspects in the area of climate change and disaster risk finance and insurance. We as Mahila Housing Trust India are fully supporting this initiative. In our own work, we are following the mission to organize and empower women in poor communities to improve their habitat. Through our grassroots program on habitat development, climate resilience and participatory governance, MHT empowers women to exercise their rights and uplift living conditions for their families, communities, and at a city level. Speaking from experience, I know very well that if women are provided with scientific knowledge and tools to undertake risk assessments, and if equipped with resilient technologies and financial solutions, it leads to an increase in uptake of locally relevant and climate resilient solutions. In fact, one can witness tangible gains for communities and cities from such women's empowerment efforts. The sisters we work with are influencing governance, planning, and may I stress that they are ensuring adaptation measures are in place at the household, community, and city levels. Furthermore, we are building on our grassroots experience to support women's groups, promote policy and regulatory changes towards more inclusive planning, and to reduce the barriers for access to finance. We are starting from something as basic as explaining about risk and what ignoring climate risks could do to livelihoods and well-being immediately and in the long run. Next year, under the framework of the Center of Excellence, we will jointly commission research together with the Ensure Resilience Global Partnership on the poverty-related barriers for access to climate and disaster risk finance and insurance. This study will unpack barriers and enabling factors for inclusive climate and disaster risk finance and insurance solutions, and will provide recommendations that can inspire other stakeholders and communities on the design and implementation of well-considered projects suitable for people living in varying levels of poverty. The Center of Excellence is a community-driven platform supported by the members of the INSU Resilience Global Partnership. With deep appreciation to the governments of Germany and Canada for their contribution in scaling up the Center of Excellence, its capacity and research to accelerate sector-wide transformation towards a gender-smart approach. To eliminate the gender gaps that put people at risk, we must work closely together to better understand the root causes of risk and to initiate joint action at a global as well as local level. This Gender Day provides a new impetus to flourish our collaboration towards a shared vision and common goals for equality and climate justice.